of a graduated income tax. The more you make, the more they take. That's Karl Marx's idea. Okay? He said you need to abolish rights of inheritance. The Bible says a good man leaveth an inheritance to his children's children. Karl Marx was against that. Confiscate property rights. Evolution's a foundation of communist philosophy behind the money powers. Karl Marx said we need a central bank. This was a communist idea. The banking system we're using today in America, the Federal Reserve, is a direct result of Karl Marx's thinking. Nothing federal about it. It's private bankers that run our currency. The Bible says love of money, root of all evil. All evil. What you need to do is real simple. You follow the yellow brick road. By the way, that whole movie was made to teach us something very interesting. The yellow brick road, the land of Oz, O-Z, ounces, gold. They had a straw man, no brain. Tin man, no heart. That's commerce, is heartless. A long, interesting story behind that, the real meaning behind that movie. We've got to cover much more on that on the college class, CSE 103. Karl Marx, one of his ideas was government ownership of communication, like our FCC, or transportation, like the TSA. Karl Marx's idea, see, the government's going to take over transportation. They've already taken over the airports, haven't they? Try to fly. I fly 215 times a year, last year. Just see what you got to go through with government regulation in transportation. Government ownership of factories and agriculture. Government control of labor. This was all Marx's idea. Corporate farms and regional planning. Everything exactly backwards to Christianity. Free education for all in public schools. That was Karl Marx's idea. Our public school system. Hitler said, let me control the textbooks, I'll control the state. Martin Luther said, I am very much afraid that the schools will prove to be the great gates to hell unless they diligently labor in explaining the scriptures, engraving them on the hearts of the youth. I advise no one to place his child where the scriptures do not reign paramount. Every institution in which men are not increasingly occupied with the Word of God must become corrupt. Here's a 1777 school book used here in America, the New England Primer. They taught the kids the alphabet using poems like this. In Adam's fall, we sinned all. Heaven to find, the Bible mind. Christ crucified, for sinners died. Can you believe that's a public school textbook? Here's how the kids learned their alphabet again. A wise son maketh a glad father. Bible verses for all the letters of the alphabet. You ought to read Fourth Reich of the Rich if you want to study more on education and how money powers have gotten involved in this. But communism is totally anti-Christian in every possible way. This is the communist rules for revolution. Number one, you corrupt the young. Cover much more on that on video college class 103. Break down the moral virtues. Just incredible the way this is what they've done. Corrupt the young. Get them away from religion. Break down the moral virtues. Encourage a soft government attitude toward crime. You know, three strikes and you're out. How about one strike and you're out? Where's the victim's rights in all this? Divide the people into hostile groups. Get the people's minds off their government. Focus their attention on athletics. Get people more worried about, you know, soccer or football than what the government's doing. You know, in 1896, there were 311 athletes in the Olympics. And 100 years later, there were 13,000. There are probably people in this room that know more about the local sports team or the Green Bay Packers than you do about who's the senators from your state. Our minds are off our government, all right. Control all media, like CNN, the Communist News Network. Don't get me started on the media, okay? Destroy people's faith in their leaders, okay? Lenin said, those who cast the votes decide nothing. Those who count the votes decide everything. Interesting thinking. Who's programming these voting booths that are counting the votes, ballots by computers? Who's programming this computer? Go to Vote Scam on the internet. Just type in Vote Scam and see what you find, okay? Cause the registration of firearms so that you can eventually confiscate them. Gun control, communist idea. Lenin said one person with a gun can control 100 people without one. Imagine the scene. You're standing in a bank trying to cash a check. Somebody runs in there with a gun, pulls out a gun, and says, everybody lay on the floor. So everybody lays on the floor. Now imagine this scene. Every citizen is armed. The guy runs in the bank, lay on the floor. Everybody pulls out their gun. You lay on the floor while we all stomp on your head. Okay. Every dictator throughout history has wanted gun control. It's just a normal thing. You have to control the guns. Every dictator's wanted that. We cover much more on that in our College Class 103 about the gun control. Gun control is not about guns. It's about control. Somebody sent me this button as a joke. Proudly unarmed. Would you wear this? What does this say to a criminal? Rob me. Isn't that what it says? At a very early age, Comrade Stalin went to a Christian school and he read Darwin's book and became an atheist. That's the book that changed Joseph Stalin's life forever. Joseph Stalin killed between 60 and 100 million of his own people. You should read anything by Alexander Solzhenitsyn, like the Archipelago Gulag, you know, the concentration camp. He spent 10 years in Stalin's concentration camps. One of my daughter-in-law is from Ukraine. I used to have 7 people on our staff from former Soviet countries. We know what they do over there. When Germany and Russia attacked Poland during World War II, Poland, you know, was just totally overwhelmed and no chance of survival in a situation like that. They captured all these Polish officers. They asked Stalin, what should we do with the officers? He said, oh, they're just Poles, execute them. They finally admitted it in 1992. The Russians finally admitted, yep, we killed 14,700 officers at the Katyn Forest. Massacred them. Why? Well, if you believe in evolution, you think you're superior because they're just inferior. You know, it's really best to wipe them out. It's like pulling weeds. It's all it is. Pol Pot, the leader of Cambodia during Cambodian Reign of Terror, killed 1/3 of his own population. I don't recommend you watch The Killing Fields. It's a pretty vile movie, but boy, it's pretty accurate. I mean, that's what they did. They killed people by the tens of thousands for any reason. When the communists took over China, they began killing Christians at a rate of 15,000 a month. Missionaries that were there reported, those that survived, that came, got out of China, said, you know what was strange? When they came into our village, the communists came in, they didn't start teaching communism in the schools. The first thing they did in the schools was start teaching evolution. The communists know full well evolution is the foundation for communism. Russian atheist astronomer said, either there is a God or there isn't. Both possibilities are frightening. See, if there's no God, man's in charge. You put man in charge, you're asking for disaster. Okay? Evolution theory is dangerous. It brings forth bad fruit. It's a corrupt tree. And instead of plucking the branches off, fighting abortion and all these things, which I think we should do, go for the root, man. Fight the main philosophy behind it. The Bible says the earth is the Lord's. This whole problem started 6,000 years ago. God created everything. Lucifer decided he wanted to be God. Probably about 100 years after the creation is when Lucifer fell. I don't know. We cover some of that on video too. But Lucifer started this long war against God. Ezekiel tells us a little bit about it. It says iniquity was found in him. He was perfect until iniquity was found in him. He was lifted up because of his beauty, because of his power, because of his riches. He's the one that weakened the nations. Isaiah tells us, how have you fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, thou son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? Lucifer's causing this problem. He decided, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. Bible says, yet thou shalt be brought down to hell, to the sides of the pit. They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee and consider, saying, is this the man that made the nations tremble? How many saw the movie Wizard of Oz? Remember when they finally pulled the curtain back and there's the great Oz, you know? Is this the man? This is it? That's Oz?